The North Koreans have been extremely resistant to any kind of strong verification measures. The North Koreans have never acknowledged having any nuclear facilities outside the Yongbyon Nuclear Center, which is where IAEA inspectors have gone off and on over many years. They've never been willing to admit that they have any additional nuclear facilities, which we know is not true. There's never been any international access to their missile production facilities, much less deployed missiles or nuclear weapons. So I think when Secretary Pompeo sits down with his North Korean counterpart to be named, I thought it was a bit curious that the summit communique didn't mention who his counterpart would be. Maybe there's some jockeying inside North Korea for who gets the pleasure of negotiating with Secretary Pompeo. But when the secretary sits down, I think all of these issues are going to very quickly become apparent. And the U.S. idea that we can get North Korea to disarm in a short period of time, to first declare, then freeze, then reduce, then eliminate to our satisfaction before we give them economic and political benefits, this is just not going to work. And the Trump administration at some point will have to decide whether they compromise to keep the process alive or whether they try to back out of the diplomacy and go back to maximum pressure and bloody nose.